Hello and welcome. Thanks for joining us. We've got baseball on the show. It's the New York Mets taking on the San Francisco Giants. First pitch coming your way next. Just about set to go now. And today on the hill, Blake Snell.
Yeah, and when he's on, he's a real treat to watch. I become a fan myself. You know, he often takes the pressure off of his hitters to score a lot of runs, but they have to be careful to not just go into a slumber. They've got to put up some runs, make it a little bit easier for this guy so he doesn't have to battle every time that he's out there. No one should be surprised, though, if he settles in and takes control of the game and throws a shutout.
Now it's the veteran outfielder, Brandon Nimmo. Fought off foul. The wide to kick the pitch. Swing and a ball lifted left field. And no one can get to it. It's a foul ball. Foul ball still, 1-2 count. And now the lefty gets a piece and stays alive. Pitch misses outside. The count now 2-2. Bounce that off to the left and we'll do it again. The lefty fires. In the air, pretty deep out to center field. Lee sizes this one up, and there's one down. Here's a Mets lineup now. They're dealing with a top-level arm on the mound, so this figures to be a tough matchup for them. What's the key to the offense today, Singy?
Oh, Boog, I think when you got a guy that's this talented on the mound, you got to find ways to disrupt his rhythm, make him uncomfortable a little bit. The guys that can handle the bat and perhaps, you know, bunt for a base hit, get him moving off the mound. If you're in the box and he seems to be just in a flow, step out, mess up his timing, somehow try to get in his head a little bit. And then when he does come in the zone, you may only get one pitch. You better not miss it.
The first baseman, Pete Alonso.
Here's Pete Alonso. And Singy, as a team, you need to make the most of the very few opportunities he's going to give you, right?
Absolutely. And you know, if you don't get to guys like this a lot of times early, once they really settle in, it's going to be the later innings that they hand that ball over to a reliever, if they do at all.
Hits and misses. It's a strikeout. Mets go down quickly. Now it's the Giants' turn. No score. You're dialed into the show. Back here in San Francisco and pitching in this game, Sean Manaea.
Well, he comes at hitters with a 5-pitch mix, so for him it's always interesting to see how he utilizes those weapons. He may lean on 1 or 2 pitches depending on how things are going and how things are working, but if he can control 4 or even 5 of those offerings, look out, hitters, it's gonna be a tough day. He's really gonna be able to keep those guys off balance.
Bottom of the first, here's the center fielder, Jung Hoon Lee. This one in the air right field. Marte going after it. No trouble here. Puts it away for the out. And there's one down. Here's the Giants lineup. We could be in for a power showcase today with the wind blowing out a lot of lift and separate, Chris.
We know guys are in this era definitely trying to hit the ball in the air regardless of the conditions, but I think even a little more so, there's margin for error if you can get the ball up in the air. So, you know, you'll see at times, I'm sure, with 2 strikes, what looks like a half swing that can get out of the ballpark with a guy who's got decent pop.
And downstairs, 1 out, base is empty. Right through there for a strike. The wind of the pitch. A dive, he's got it. fires to first, and they get the out.
Batting third, the first baseman, Wilbur Flores.
And now it's Wilmer Flores. Two down, nobody on. Swing and a miss.
One ball, two strikes.
Got him looking. And a nice inning of work there as he sets him down 1-2-3. Giants go down quietly, scoreless after one. Back here at Oracle Park, second inning set to go. And here is J.D. Martinez. He's a guy who does it all. With the lack of contact in today's game, this guy hits for contact, so he delivers average, but there's on base and slugging too. The pitch. A little out front there as he swings through.
Early in the count, you have to be real careful because of that power, but then if this hitter gets a strike or two on him, he's still very comfortable. And because he has the ability to get the barrel to the baseball, he's a threat deep into the count as well.
The 1-2. Gets a piece there. We'll do it again. The wind of the pitch. That one way inside. We chase that time. The pitch. That one down the line, and that's just foul. Three and two now. And a swing and a miss. He didn't make it easy for him on the mound, but they still get the strikeout.
Boog gets talked about a lot, but a good high fastball in a two-strike situation, it's just become such a problem for hitters in more recent years. But with all of the emphasis by pitchers on developing that spin rate, having a good grip on the baseball, those high fastballs, they kind of look like to the hitter that they're rising, even though they're not, but they're not decreasing in velocity and spin rate. So very difficult to get the barrel on it.
The pitch. Line drive, base hit, right field. So a man aboard now with one away.
Hey, whatever works, right? Doesn't have to be impressive. You'll take those bloop hits off the end of the bat all day long. It doesn't mean you put a great swing on it, but hitters deserve to get a lucky hit every now and then.
Starling Marte up to hit. Kicks and fires. That misses. Now two balls and a strike. McNeil leads off first with one away. Ground ball left side, could be two. Off balance feed, there's one. And that's two. One hit in the inning, but no one left. Now to the bottom of the second. We're tied, nothing, nothing. Bottom of the second. Matt Chapman up to the plate now. It's interesting. He plays kind of a power spot defensively, but runs pretty well. So when you're looking at that position, you're not expecting someone that has maybe above average speed, but he does. Brings it in with a nice running grab. And there's one away. Michael Conforto will climb in. Second inning here. No score. That It's in there, and it's 1-2.
Man, I mean, nice job just presenting it to be better than it actually was.
Swing and a miss, struck him out, and now two gone.
Oh, really expanded the zone right there with that fastball off the outside corner of the plate. Got him to chase it. That's a tough one to lay off of because it starts close to you and just continues to run away from you in that batter's box. So it's a really nice pitch with two strikes.
Mike Yastrzemski up here. Two outs. Swing and a miss. And the count 1-2.
Two strikes.
That one to first. He takes it himself to the bag, and that'll do it. Giants are down 1-2-3. We'll move to the third with no score. On to the third inning, and here's the catcher, Francisco Alvarez.
Francisco Alvarez.
Here's a 1-1. On its way to the corner, and that will drop foul. The wind of the pitch. This one smoked out to left. Puts it away for the out. One down. And next for the Mets, Brett Beatty.
Blake Snell on the mound today, and everyone knows he's got a great shoe collection, but his trophy cabinet's pretty full as well. He's won multiple Cy Young Awards, one in the American League with the Rays and another in the National League with the Padres.
Top of the third, no score.
Snell won his second Cy Young Award in 2023, the same season he led the majors in walks. That doesn't happen very often, but it wasn't the first time. Early Wynn did the same thing in 1959 with the Chicago White Sox.
And he deals. Goes down swinging for the strikeout. Pulled the string of the changeup.
He came out of his mechanics there. Typically likes to shoot the ball the other way, but that time, a little anxious.
And now Bader up to the plate. Right field down the line, and that one slices foul. Two outs, bases empty.
Whoa, that's down.
It's a good take.
And the pitch. Battling here as he fouls it away. Two down, nobody on. Still 2-2 after the foul ball. Eighth pitch of the at bat coming up. Spoils that one, and it remains 2-2. Two outs. In the air, left field, down the line, and that drops foul. And a pitch. Swing and a foul straight back. And a pitch.
We got a full count.
Wow, this guy's really battling up there as if his run is the game-winning run. I love his tenacity.
Payoff pitch. Stays alive. 3-2. Spoils the two-strike pitch, and he'll see another. Kicks and deals. Ground ball up the middle. On the run, throw to first. They get the out, and that'll do it. Down in order go the Mets. And we're still knotted at zero. And welcome back to the ballpark. Set for the bottom of the third. Here's the second baseman, Tyrell Estrada. Swing and a miss. And a count one and two.
One ball, two strikes.
That one drifts inside.
Really good take, especially with two strikes.
The pitch. Here's a rocket out to left. He's got it. One up, one down.
Battinger, the catcher, Patrick.
Patrick Bailey, the next to hit. This guy, one of the best defensive catchers going. You talk about framing, the ability to block, catch, and throw. He is at the top of the game. Base hit, center field. So they get a man aboard with a one-out single.
I'm sure he feels really good about that one. Off the bat, that one registered at 105 miles per hour, man. That is smoking. And these days, you hear it all the time, but the numbers just don't lie. If you can drive a ball like that, more often than not, you're picking up a knock.
Nick Ahmed here to hit. And a 2-1 on the way. Swing and a miss.
Two balls, two strikes.
Bailey leads off first with one away. Swings and misses, struck him out.
Now got it.
So the lineup flips over. Now it's the Giants leadoff hitter, Jung-Hoon Lee. Second, pulls him off the bag.
You know, two-run errors are kind of like two-out walks, and sometimes even worse. You know, you think you're out of the inning, but all of a sudden, you get another out to get, and the offense has a great opportunity they're looking to take advantage of and make you pay for.
Jorge Soler up at the plate.
Side right there, but he didn't spin off of it. That's the key. You still have to extend through the baseball in order to hit a line drive like that.
So digging in, Wilmer Flores. Two on, two outs. This one in the dirt. Nothing happening on the bases, though. Pitch that clips the corner. At the belt and fires on the ground to first. He'll do it himself. Inning over, and it could have been worse, but the RBI single pushes across a run. It's now 1-0. It's Major League Baseball on the show. And we're back. Here's the left fielder, Brandon Nimmo.
Number 9, Brandon Nimmo. Swing and a miss as he was out front that time. Next pitch misses inside. Two balls, two strikes. High fly ball down the left field line. And an automatic double now as it hops the wall in foul ground.
Well, that was a circus type play right there. First it started with a bad angle and then needing to jump to try to get up and make the catch. Just a bad look all the way around.
Here's Francisco Lindor. Here comes a pitch. And that one fouled off. And a pitch. Foul ball, another 2-2 upcoming. Tying run in scoring position. Top half of inning number four. In the dirt. Well done behind the dish. Foul ball, he stays alive. Man at second. And ball four to aboard. It wasn't easy, but he earned that walk after a long at bat.
He's making things difficult for himself right now out there on the mound. But, you know, his confidence should still be high enough to get out of this, but he's going to have to buckle down right here.
Pitch. Bounding ball here. Rolls foul.
Well, he put good velocity in the head of the hitter. He's got to get it ready early and then change speeds. Keep him off balance. That's the goal.
The pitch. And another ball. First and second here. No outs. Here's a high chopper, Flores. Ahmed for one. Two gone as they head into their second double play in the first four innings.
The 3-6-1 double play, in my opinion, is one of the toughest plays to make. You've got a pitcher covering first, and the middle infielder throwing to a moving target. Everything has to be perfect, and right there, they made it look pretty easy.
J.D. Martinez stands in. Two outs. That misses outside, the zone, and a count 2-1. And now the lefty up the middle. Tosses to first, and Martinez is out. That's out number three. So a leadoff double, but they can't cash it in. On now to the bottom of the fourth. It's the Giants 1 and the Mets nothing. Back here in San Francisco, bottom four. Now Matt Chapman at the plate.
Matt Chapman.
The 1-1. And there's a foul ball. Out towards left center. Nimmo has it sized up. And it's caught for the out.
The left fielder, number 8.
The batter will be Michael Conforto.
Conforto.
Base is empty, one away. We're here in the bottom of the fourth. So a foul ball makes it 1-2. One down, base is empty. Bounce to the right side, and it goes just foul. And that's in the dirt.
Two strikes.
Swung on and missed. Struck him out. And there's two away.
Just indecisive in that at bat. He couldn't commit to the slider. Tried to sit in between. Just not able to put the bat on the ball.
Here comes Mike Yastrzemski to the plate. Two down, nobody on. So a foul ball makes it 1-2. That one almost got him. Just missing there. And that's ball three. Fights it off. He'll see another. That one ripped. That's down. One hops off the wall. And that's a two-out double.
Everything came together perfectly for him right there.
Got a good pitch to drive, stayed short with his bat path to the ball, and caught it out front, and he stayed long in his follow-through. That's how you split the gap, and that's pretty much a double every time.
Tyrell Estrada to the plate. Man on second, two down. Foul ball there. Keeps the at bat going with a foul ball. The pitch. Rounds third, headed for the plate. He scores, and they take a two-run lead. Estrada into second, and he's got a double.
Puts a run on the board and picks up an RBI. Just a solid swing right there. Caught it out front and ripped it into the outfield for the base hit. Those always feel great.
Patrick Bailey, the next Giant to hit. Kicks and fires. Runner takes off. There's a ball. Out at third. And that ends the inning. Giants get a run on the RBI double. It's now a 2-0 ball game. You're watching Major League Baseball on the show. And welcome back to the ballpark. Top five, John Schaube with Chris Singleton. And leading it off, Jeff McNeil.
Let's go,
Here it comes. Battling here as he fouls it away. The wind of the pitch. Now a screamer into the outfield. Lee calls it in, and there's one away. Here's Starling Marte. The Giants up by two, and we're at the top of the fifth. Big swing and a miss. I think it was setting off speed there. Swings, throw it in, that's a strikeout.
Really went aggressive in with that slider. Good two-strike pitch right there. At worst-case scenario, it's weak contact in play. Exactly where he and the catcher wanted it.
Two outs. Popped up. Drifts towards it. Makes the grab, and that's the inning. Nothing doing for the Mets. They trail things here 2-0. Back now to start the bottom of the fifth, and taking over on the mound, Drew Smith.
Well, at this point of the ball game, we're talking about middle innings, and you need a little length out of this arm coming out of the bullpen. We'll see just how many outs he's able to give his skipper.
Here's the catcher to hit, Patrick Bailey. This is a guy who is very highly regarded defensively. Fun to watch him control stuff behind the plate. Good game caller, good at framing, but it's that big arm that really stands out.
That's a ball.
Off the mark there. And a count, 2-1.
Yeah, and because he's got the big arm, he pays attention to the running game and is sure to manage it.
Next offering is in for a strike.
When you have a catcher that can throw like that, a pitcher doesn't have to worry as much about the slide step. He can keep his mechanics intact and have a better opportunity of getting that hitter out with a swing and miss.
That's out to center field. Bader should have it. And there's one away.
The batter, the shortstop.
Nick Ahmed, the next Giant to hit. This is a guy who's in the lineup first and foremost because of what he contributes defensively, Chris. And when you talk about preventing runs from being scored, this guy is a big contributor.
One ball, two strikes.
I was always told it's hard to take you off the field when you play really good defense, especially at a premier position. And that's what he does.
And a 1-2. And a pop-up, right side, foul territory. Alvarez has room, and he makes the catch. And there are two down.
Jung-Hoon Lee.
So two down now, and here is Jung-Hoon Lee. Two down, nobody on. Last half of inning number five. Two down, nobody on. Cold strike three on the fastball, and that ran back over the inner half. Nothing doing there for San Francisco. They're up 2-0. Back here at Oracle Park, here's the third baseman, Brett Beatty.
Brett Beatty.
The 2-1. Fastball, and he gets out of the way.
Well, these Mets, simply put, are producing a lot of quality swings. A handful have turned into outs, but of the balls they've put in play, 10 have been line drives. I say keep barreling the ball and good things will happen. Don't let that get you frustrated.
The wind of the pitch. Fouls that off to the left, and we'll do it again. Knocks that one away, and we'll do it again. Three, two on the way. Foul off the plate, they'll do it again. The wide to kick the pitch. And he found for the play.
He's got to throw any pitch in any count. 3-2. He goes off speed. Gets the out.
Harrison Bader will hit next. One down, base is empty. Rolled over to third. And he grabs it. Foul. The wind of the pitch. That one ripped left field. That's back there. And it's into the bleachers. Out of here. And they're on the board. It's 2-1.
Well, there goes the shutout. Just like that. They're still behind, but this is a start.
Gee,
changeup up in the zone is a hitter's dream. It's a BP fastball, but you're playing in real time. Most times, the pitcher's asking for a new baseball, just like right there.
Here comes the skipper, and we're going to see a pitching change in this spot. Blake Snell departs, and as he heads for the dugout, we'll take a quick break. New arm on the mound when we get back. New arm for the Giants, Kaiwei Teng.
And this is an important part of this game. Tight score and still a lot of outs to get. So they're looking for a big outing out of him right here to get some critical outs.
Here's Brandon Nimmo. Left-hand batter waits. Stays alive. Right-hander kicks, deals. Still 2-2 after the foul ball. The Giants up by a run, and we're at the top half of the sixth. Lifted in the air, right field. Yastrzemski sizing this one up and makes the grab. And there are two outs.
Now that.
And now it's Frankie Lindor. Left field. And that's a fair ball. Takes the turn. He's digging for second. The throw in, but he's in there easily.
Well, those kind of lucky soft hits will always make you smile. Kind of your classic jam shot blooper right there. Paid a good pitch on the inside, gotten to hit it off the handle, but he still muscled it out there. You just have to tip your cap on the mound. Now a pretty big at bat coming up with a chance to even this ball game up.
And now it's the polar bear, Pete Alonso.
Ball three.
It's a little bit low. And there's ball four.
Outside of the bullpen can absolutely kill your momentum very quickly. They're in some hot water trying to protect this lead.
Here's J.D. Martinez.
Well, look out here. He's going to come up ready to swing in this situation.
And the right-hander deals. Comes up empty. That's strike two.
One ball, two strikes.
Pitch misses, and the count is even, 2-2. Swing and a miss, and that is that.
A lot of adrenaline, we can see it right there, and sometimes you just got to let it out. That's an outstanding job of taking that, executing, and getting out of a tough inning.
Of the inning. Here's a big power threat. Jorge Soler.
Jorge Soler.
The 1-2. And another ball. Right-handed reliever. Spoils that one, and it remains 2-2. Righty delivers. Chopped left side. Bounces into the outfield. Base hit.
Couple of hits in a row for him here. Just found a way to slap that ball down the third baseline. That's really excellent back control, and it kind of goes back to all those drills you see hitters do off the tee where it's placed in different spots. That was just nice.
Now a chance for Wilmer Flores.
All these Giants putting together some really good at-bats in this game. There's been a lot to like with how they're approaching their chances at the plate. They really made that opposing starter work in this one. Ran his pitch count up, and now they've got an opportunity to continue making things difficult on the bullpen.
The 2-2. Bounce to the left side. Lays out, but he can't squeeze it. Throw off, oh, he's safe. And a nice job there to keep it from getting away.
Well, you can't give him two errors on that play, but that's pretty much what it looked like. Tried to stay with it after the bobble, and he might have pulled it off with a good throw, but it's very easy to rush the throw when you don't field it cleanly. A lot of times guys don't have a good grip on it, and I think that was the case right there.
And here is Matt Chapman. And the pitch. And now one and two.
One ball, two strikes.
No outs, runners at first and second. Bounce it off, still one and two. And a pitch. Swing and a miss, struck him out.
Typically that high fastball, if it's close to the top of the strike zone, a hitter, if he's prepared for it, can get to it. But that one just had that little jump at the end, which indicates there's a good spin rate on it, and it didn't decrease in velocity as that hitter's internal clock would expect it to, and that's why you see the swing and miss.
Mike Yastrzemski on deck for San Francisco.
Well, I think really just trying to be careful, man, in scoring position there. See if he can somehow navigate through this lineup, get a more favorable matchup, perhaps get him a rollover on a changeup, get a ball on the ground, get a double play, and get out of this.
He's got it. Two down.
Up next, John. The white field.
So first and second with two outs. Now here is Mike Yastrzemski. Two on, two outs, and they're all loaded up.
Well, the stage has been set for this offense, Boo. It's all about creating opportunities, and this is one of them right here.
And now Tyro Estrada. Soler at third, Flores on second, Yastrzemski at first, two out of the inning. That one missed.
Morgan, situations like these, the air can get really thin up there at the plate. Got to find a way to breathe and slow everything down.
Into score.
Really got himself into a mess out there and now forces home a run with the wall. This inning's definitely getting away from him.
Two outs, bases full. Patrick Bailey getting ready to hit. And the righty deals. Swings through that one for strike two.
One ball, two strikes.
Bases loaded, two down. On the ground at first. Tosses to the pitcher covering the bag. They limit the damage here. So they get one, but end up leaving the bases loaded. We're through six full. It's the Giants three and the Mets one. Welcome back. We're in the seventh. We have a new pitcher on the mound. Number 74.
And we all know about his slider. It's just filthy, man. And one of the better ones in the game, I'd say. Spin rate's very high, and it just breaks a ton.
Jeff McNeil stands in. He's kind of an outlier, especially when guys are consciously sacrificing contact to deliver power. And a pitch. Swing and a miss. Now one and two.
Yeah, his swing is so good. It's in the zone a long time. He gets the barrel to it a lot, and that produces more base hits.
And now the count is even. When you look at the elite teams in the game right now, there is going to be the slug, no question about it. But the really good offensive teams combine slug with more contact, with less swing and miss. Kicks and deals. Swings through that one. It's a strikeout. A big first out here in the seventh via the punch out.
Yeah, it just does so much to change the outlook of an important inning like this. When you have a leadoff hitter, so critical in setting the table when you got a tight game like this. So a strikeout really puts them on their heels.
Now, Starling Marte. Strike two. The Giants leading by two here in the top half of inning number seven. Hard on the ground to first. Marte retired.
Now back. Captain Francisco Alvarez.
Digging in, Francisco Alvarez. Two outs. Swings through that one out in front that time.
Well, in this one, the offense has sputtered. Somebody's got to find a way to get on, keep the line moving, and manufacture at least one run. Then maybe you get two or three.
At the belt and fires. Started after it. Appeal to first. And he won around. Not an easy call there, but that puts an end to the inning. And the Mets go down 1-2-3. And they still trail it here 3-1. We're back in a new pitcher here to start the bottom of the seventh. Jorge Lopez.
Just trying to keep this one close here. And this is where a bullpen can give their players a chance to fight back into the game.
Nick Ahmed digs in now.
The shortstop, Nick Ahmed.
Next offering is in for a strike. On the ground, Lindor. And one away in the bottom of the seventh.
The bat, the center fielder, Jung-Hoon Lee.
So the batting order turns over. Jung-Hoon Lee, the next Giant to hit. That one at the knees for a strike. Meanwhile, activity in the bullpen. Jake Diekman getting ready to go. Base is empty, one away here at the bottom of the seventh. Out to short, Lindor. Tosses to first, two up, two down.
Hey, man, four pitches, two outs. That is an excellent pace.
Jorge
Soler, the next Giant to hit. And a 1-1. In the air, right field. Hauls it in to end the inning. Welcome back, and a new arm on the mound to start the eighth. Taylor Rogers.
These are the spots where relievers really make a name for themselves, late and close. There's not much margin for error, but at the same time, there's a reason they're put in these situations.
And stepping in for New York, Brett Beatty.
The third baseman, Brett Beatty.
On the ground to the left, and foul ball. Back to work, 3-2 now. And he grounds one to the right side. Fires over to first. First out in the top of the eighth.
Now back. the center fielder, Harrison Bader.
And now the center fielder, Harrison Bader. You talk about elite defensive players, especially in the middle of the diamond, and this guy is at the top of the list. And he's swinging a miss. And you play behind guys, and they love having your speed out there defensively. One of the things that we talk about is how much pitchers enjoy having those elite defenders behind them. Lefty continues to work, but the closer getting loose in the bullpen. The swing and a soft liner. Hauls it in, two away.
It's never fun going back to the dugout after hitting a line drive that finds a glove, but you will get some high fives. You know, when you make great contact, you feel like you've done everything right. But in this game of baseball, not everything is in your control.
So up next for New York, Brandon Nimmo. Two down, nobody on, and we're in the top of the eighth.
Hanging in there pretty good against the lefty.
Two down, nobody on. And another ball. Francisco Lindor up next for the Mets. Good battle here. About to be the eighth pitch of the at-bat. And he walked
that
him. That's a great at bat. He saw a lot of pitches and earned a walk.
Well, he tried to nibble right there and just missed his spot. Hitter didn't offer at it. Now he has somebody to worry about over at first.
Camilo Doval comes on now.
Well, the best relievers love the opportunity to come in and protect a tight lead late in the ball game. Some of them are just wired different, so we'll see what he's got here.
Francisco Lindor comes up to the plate. Tying run at the plate. The shortstop takes the ball. That one misses. And now three balls and a strike. Pete Alonso waiting on deck if they extend the inning.
Plenty of pop in his bat, so he could give them the lead with one swing if he gets the chance.
The tying run at the plate. That clips the corner.
3-2, two out, runner on first. A lot of movement in the infield. Hitter's got to stay focused on the pitch.
Swing and a ground ball up the middle. That's a base hit. Nimmo around second, headed for third. Headed for the plate. Relay throw home. He's safe.
Well done. Drives in the run. Diving on the swing was good. Shoot the ball up the middle. Didn't square it up as much as he probably would have liked, but that's a good approach paying off.
Two outs, runner at first. And now the first baseman, Pete Alonso. Two outs. And it is 2-1.
Right now they're looking for something. Hit hard into the gaps. Give them an opportunity with two outs to score that run from first.
And there's a ball with a single base runner. Because of all the power, they are dangerous to tie this thing up or take the lead. J.D. Martinez, the kind of bat that can make a big impact if they can keep it going here. The right-hander gives up the two-out walk.
Pretty much the last thing you want from your bullpen arms are free passes, especially in spots like this. Make the team earn their way out.
And now J.D. Martinez. Fly ball down the line. and that is a foul ball. Big spot. Two out. Both the tying and go-ahead runs are aboard. Pitch misses there. It's 2-2. Good chase that time. So both runners should be on the move here on the full count pitch.
Yeah, this is a good chance to tie up this ball game. See if he can find some open grass in the outfield.
So the tying run at second. Swing and a foul ball at the plate. They'll do it again. He fouls it off. We'll do it again. Payoff pitch. Hacks and misses. It's a strikeout.
Sometimes he wears the emotion on the sleeve, but that's okay as long as he's getting results. And right there, thrilled with the punch out to get out of a jam.
And we're back. And here's the first baseman, Wilmer Flores.
Wilmer. Flores.
The pitch.
One ball, two strike.
And a pitch. Not close with that one. Now 2-2.
Well, he might have to look for a different put away pitch right here, 2-2. He's already seen the curveball a couple of times in this at bat, so might have it timed up and ready for it.
Next offering misses, and the count's full. And that's ball four.
That's inside. Ball four.
Well, a great back and forth in that at bat. He had to lay off some really close pitches, and somehow Bogey found a way to keep the bat on his shoulder right there. I'll tell you right now, I couldn't have done it.
The pitch. That's down and in. Swing and he breaks his bat. Lindor, that's one. Over to first, safe.
Good arm side run to that same side hitter right there. Very difficult to put that ball in the air or get through it. Just bores in on the hands.
And here is Michael Conforto. One run game, one out, one on. Breaking ball inside. And it's 2-1. Bounced up the middle. Tossed to Alonso. Got the out.
The right fielder, number five.
And digging in for San Francisco, Mike Yastrzemski. And it's second. Rolled softly, but that goes foul. Here comes a pitch. That misses. 2-2. Runner at second, two down. Here in the bottom half of the eighth inning. Just misses. And it's 3-2. Tyro Estrada getting on deck circle. Man on second, two down. And that one hammered. This one's got a chance. And that one is off the top of the wall. Run comes in from second, and they lead by two.
Got the job done to put him up by two. Just missed out on a home run right there, but he certainly hit it hard enough. Just didn't have the right launch angle to carry it over the wall, but still an excellent swing of the bat.
Now it's the second baseman, Tyro Estrada. 3-2. A base hit around third. Here's the throw to the plate. The tag, and he's safe.
Picks himself up at RBI. Once you get the ball by the pitcher, there's a lot of base hits up the middle, even on ground balls. So a nice job to use that big hole and get himself a hit.
Righty reliever out of the pen, Grant Hartwig.
Pretty tight game, so they're looking for quality pitches out of him right here. Got to do his best to keep the score right where it is.
Patrick Bailey, the next Giant to hit. To the right side. Has some trouble with it. Wins the race to the bag, and they get it out of the play. So it's two runs on two hits, no errors, and a runner left. Ninth inning coming up. It's the Giants 5 and the Mets 2. Back here in San Francisco, all set to start the ninth in this one. And now here's Jeff McNeil. The 1-1. And another ball.
Two balls, one strike.
Bounced up the middle, and it's through for a hit. Man aboard on the leadoff single. Singy, that's a start.
Yeah, as soon as that ball got through, I could see down in the dugout, guys pumping their fists. They know that they got a chance in this ballgame.
Tyler Rogers on the pitch here.
And I can't imagine any save is an easy one. You're holding a small lead on the scoreboard, and you know those hitters are going to give you the best at-bats they can. So it's always high stress. Let's see what he's got here to try and close it out.
So man aboard, Starling Marte up now for the Mets. And now 2-2.
If you want to get something going, this is the time to do it. You get the leadoff man on. Everybody's got to look over the shoulder and say, I'm just going to keep the line moving. Don't try to do too much.
The pitch. Now a high fly ball out to left center. He makes the grab. Francisco Alvarez up now for the Mets. The 1-1 is fouled off. McNeil, the runner at first with one gone in the inning. Swings and misses, struck him out.
Definitely made him chase a little bit out of the zone right there. I don't think that's a strike if he takes it. Pretty textbook pitching. Get ahead in the count, get the guy in the box on his heels, and then force him to chase your pitch where he doesn't have much of a chance to do any damage.
And here it comes. And ball four to a board.
Not what he wanted to do there, Boog. That keeps this inning alive. It gives this offense a good chance to cut into their deficit.
Harrison Bader up now for the Mets. With the tying run at the plate, here at the top of the ninth. Soft contact in the air. The catch is made to end it.
Well, this was a total team effort using six pitchers in this ballgame to get the win. Outstanding job of passing the baton. The next pitcher stepping up and getting it done. You got to give him a lot of credit because this is not easy to do. We'll see how it affects them over the next couple of days.
And your final score, 5-2. For Chris Singleton and our entire outstanding crew here at MLB The Show, I'm John Ciambi. We'll see you soon.
Five runs, seven hits, no errors. They left seven runners on base.